forgot you have a not so great cast. You had us.
And you're not saying anything.
Right. Gonna be like, what did you guys do? Did you just group me? Or did you just use like social media? Or
not doing shit.
Did you have everybody's number from last season even?
I'm sorry, 14 questions. Not really social media and phone numbers, obviously. What was your question?
Do you even have everybody's number from last season?
Yeah.
Do y'all like...
I don't use them.
Right. I don't use them.
Dude, but that's so them. Weird that you're not like super close to at least one person.
I mean, I'm close with them, but not super close.
That's just weird,
like,
man.
Not at all. Like
you
we
lived
don't talk.
With these people for like 99 days, dude. Yeah.
But you have to understand the people that I lived with for 99 days. Yeah. Do you get what I'm saying?
Yeah, I do.
This dynamic is not the dynamic from last season. At all.
Sounds terrible, dude.
It was not chill.
Training
After
driving.
This, I want to like, talk to production and be like, what all have you witnessed? Like, all of it.
Killing cats? I have one, yeah.
I have one.
Quitting Big Brother? Not that chill.
No.
No.
But yeah, phone numbers, I guess. I mean, I saw... Here's the thing. Cody came out to L.A., took me to a baseball... My first baseball game. Took me to a Dodgers game. His buddy was playing. Like, Cody's great. You know what I'm saying?
Cody Paul's brother? No, Cody.
Corey, no. I'm sorry. Corey.
I knew what you were saying.
Corey.
And I still was like, yeah, Cody.
You went to the Dodgers or Angels game?
Dodgers. I think they were versus the Angels. Mm. Anyway, versus the Red Sox. Or I don't fucking know. I don't watch baseball. Not the Red Sox. Whatever. I watched that in New York. So then I went to New York and Jose was in town and he texted me. He's like, hey, you want to go grab lunch? Grab lunch with Jose. Hey, how are you? We caught up. Done. Glenn was there. Took me to a fucking Yankees and a Red Sox game.
I thought Jose lived in L.A.
Super cool. Between L.A. and New York, he does all sorts of stuff.
Didn't you barely even get to know Jose?
Yeah, really, yeah. So, and then Paulie was in town the other week. He's like, hey, man, I'm here filming this fitness video. Like, let's grab lunch. Caught up with... It's like that, but okay. It's not like... Victor, every time he's here, obviously I link up with him.
Victor!
I feel like I'll Bronte, probably be texting a few of you guys, like, daily, though.
I hope so. Bronte, sweetheart. Bridget, keep in touch with her. But other people, it's like...
The mathematician.
I don't know. Some people are just...
Bronte was the girl that had the annoying voice, right?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah. Is that... Was that...
Nope,
she
that's
cried
how
when she
is.
Told everyone she was a mathematician.
Yeah, we were like, what the fuck? Who cares? It's not like groundbreaking news.
So funny.
Did that ever get less annoying?
No. I mean, you just got used to it.
Yeah, no, so one of my questions, and I couldn't remember her name. I just said the girl that was on season 18 that had the annoying voice.
Bronte.
Yeah, I'm like, she's awesome, but I could not deal with that.
She's a sweetheart. She's very, but she's almost too sweet. Like, it's like, too sweet, maybe you're a little gullible. I'm concerned for you in your real life.
How old was she?
26.
Oh. It can be hard to, like, banter with people that are too sweet,
I told them that I couldn't live with Victoria or Jose because all they did is talk about how awesome they were.
Wise, like it was just I did not click with these people at all. And
do you feel like you click with us?
I do.
It's just so weird to think like everything you've said after that experience, I don't think I would have been willing to do this again. Like it sounds so bad, dude. Doesn't sound like you had fun at all.
I mean, I had fun, and then like on the aftermath is super fun, and like I got to see all the people that, you know, like, the fan base and, like, what made people happy and the fan mail and the things that people said about me or what inspired them to, like, not be bullied or learn about philosophy or learn about this or the things that I preached, that made it worth it. Because, like, I get to do the same thing and hopefully spread that again. You know what I'm saying? And, like...
Well, Nicole playing again, I mean, it really helped her life out.
Yeah, but she had a pretty... I thought she had a pretty cool season, to be, for the most part.
She did. Season 16 is a cool season.
It sounds like that was a lot better than his experience, dude.
Season 16 is still like that. They're all just good people.
Right.
So it's not that the Big Brother experience creates enemies. It's just that my cast was fucking psychotic.
So if somebody came to you and was like, all right, Paul, like you have an opportunity to go back in the Big Brother house, it will be a very similar experience to last time, if not worse. Would you still have come back?
I don't know.
How were... What,
well, I don't know, because I didn't know what this experience was going to be like. I could have been walking into the same fucking thing.
Right.
So, I mean, the Big Brother experience was amazing, and I loved it for what it was, because I didn't let those other people's negativity ruin my time there. I had a fucking good time, regardless of them being there or not. And it's not like... It was just a different fun for me. I love to argue and talk shit. So, it's like, there aren't personalities here that, like, I get to really do that as well with. So that brought out like a different fun for me. Like, all right, like I love to fucking talk shit. Let's do it. Like, you want to fucking argue with me? I was studying to be a fucking lawyer, so I was like, let's fucking go, buddy. You know? So I was having fun just because of that. I like that high tension argue shit. But it was still very hostile and stressful. So it's weird. It's hard to explain. But I had a fucking good time. I didn't hate my time in the Big Brother house. It was just a difficult time.
Right.
It's not easy. I'm just saying the game is not easy. And the environment I was in was a little hostile. But it doesn't mean I didn't have
You're on the block week one, right?
Week one to three nonstop on the block. And then sprinkle it in three or four more times throughout the season.
Was there any times that you were like legitimately positive you were going home?
Oh, yes. Most of those times. So it's just different, dude. Like,
I'm gonna cook, like,
I don't know. It wasn't the big... This is a better way to put it. It wasn't the Big Brother experience that I didn't like. It was a lot of the people I was
with. It's not the Big Brother experience.
Because the fucking comps, the environment, the whole... I was fucking loving it. I love it, obviously, which is why I came back. But the people that I was with last season, not my favorite.
Right. So. Yeah. Cool. That's a good way to put
it. You guys are doing full face. You lied.
And that was like almost right off the bat. I could be like,
it's almost like
I don't fuck with
you. I know. I'm taking it really
like,
easy.
Immediately.
This
like,
is natural.
It was a personality contrast.
That's full face.
And it's not like they're bad people. It's just that I don't resonate.
Dude, it's like playing a sport that you love on a team where you don't really like the people that much.
Exactly.
Yeah. I wasn't gonna
playing a sport that you love with a team
like,
of shitty people. That was exactly what my BB18 experience was.
Gotcha.
Kind of.
I don't wear foundation. Foundation takes a lot of time.